friends, this is Dr. C.L. Patil from C.L. Pilit Academy, Associate Professor, Department of English, CCAP Degree College, Vijaipur. Today I am going to discuss the allegory of the cave taken from Plato's Republic, Book 7. It is most discussed by the critics all over the world, even today. It is the most beautiful and famous metaphor in Western philosophy. It is written in the form of a dialogue between Plato's brother Glaucon and his mentor Socrates. It is related to Plato's theory of forms, according to which the forms, that is ideas, and not the material world known to us through sensation, possess the highest and most fundamental kind of reality. Only knowledge of the forms constitute real knowledge, or what Socrates considers the good. In other words, Plato's allegory of the cave is a concept formulated by the philosopher to ponder on the nature of belief versus knowledge. We can also say that the allegory of the cave is a theory put forward by Plato concerning human perception. Plato claimed that knowledge gained through senses is no more than opinion, and that in order to have real knowledge, we must gain it through philosophical reasoning. In the allegory of the cave, Plato distinguishes between people who mistake sensory knowledge for the truth and people who really do see the truth. This part is divided into three sections. 1. The cave and the fire. 2. Three stages of liberation. And 3. The prisoner returns to the cave. To make understand allegory of the cave easier, it can be divided into 5 parts as mentioned below. The cave, the shadow, the game, the escape, and the return. Now we shall go part by part. First one, the cave. The allegory centers on an imaginary group of slaves held captive in a cave their entire life. That is, Socrates says to Glaucon to imagine a cave in which there are prisoners. The prisoners are tied to some rocks, their arms and legs are bound, their head is tied so that they cannot look at anything but the stone wall in front of them. These prisoners have been here since their birth and have never seen the world outside of the cave. That is, they do not know what is there outside the cave and how the world actually looks. Behind the prisoners is a fire. Between fire and the prisoners, there is a path, a roadway, a walkway. People outside the cave walk along with this path or walkway, carrying things on their heads, including animals, plants, food and stone. In Plato's theory, the cave represents people who believe that knowledge comes from what we see and hear in the world. what we call as empirical evidence, that is, experimental. The cave shows that believers of empirical knowledge are trapped in the cave of misunderstanding. We come to the second part, the shadow. We know that behind the prisoners is a fire. Between the fire and the prisoners, path is there. People carrying puppets or other objects on their heads. This casts a shadow on the other side of the wall. The prisoners watch these shadows, believing them to be real. In other words, imagine that you are one of the prisoners. You cannot look at anything behind or to the side of you. You must look at the wall in front of you because your hands, arms, legs are bound. Your head is tied so that you cannot move your head on the either side. When people walk along the path, walkway, you can see shadow of the objects they are carrying on the wall. Those carrying the objects speak to one another, and their voices bounce off the wall before the slaves, appearing to make the shadow speak. All the slaves have ever known are the shadows in front of them, and the sounds they believe are the sounds that the shadows make. If you had never seen the real objects even before, you would believe that the shadows of objects were real. The shadows represent the perception of those who believe empirical evidence, that is, experimental, that ensures knowledge. If you believe that what you see should be taken as truth, then you are merely seeing a shadow of the truth. In Plato's opinion, you are a pleb if you believe this. Pleb means ordinary person, not well educated. The third part, the game. Plato suggests that the prisoners begin a game of guessing which shadow would appear next on the wall. If one of the prisoners were to correctly guess, then the others would praise him as a clever and say that he were master of nature. The game represents how people believe that one person can be a master when they have knowledge of the empirical world. Plato is demonstrating that this master does not actually know any truth, and suggesting that it is ridiculous to admire someone like this. Fourth part, the escape. Suddenly, one of the slaves is unchained and forced to turn around facing the platform, and the shadow puppets seen on the wall. After his eyes adjust to the sudden glare of light, he slowly comes to realize that the shadows were not as real as he had formerly believed. They are in some sense caused by the objects that he had previously never seen. When the prisoner escapes and leaves the cave, he is shocked at the world he discovers outside the cave and does not believe it can be real. As he becomes used to his new surroundings, he realizes that his former view of reality was wrong. He begins to understand the new world and sees that sun is the source of life and goes on an intellectual journey where he discovers beauty and meaning. He sees that the former life and the guessing game they played is useless. It can be said that the slave is forced up past the platform, that is, he comes out of the cave into the real world. Of course, at first his vision is unclear, as he is not used to the brightness of the outside world, because for long years he was in the cave in dark. It takes some time to his vision to adjust, but eventually, as his vision improves, the slave sees the objects of the real world and comes to realize that even the real objects from the cave were themselves only imitation of the true reality which he is now seeing outside the cave, and that too very clearly. The escaped prisoner represents the philosopher who sees knowledge outside of the cave and outside of the senses. The sun represents philosophical truth and knowledge. His intellectual journey represents a philosopher's journey when finding truth and wisdom. Coming to the fifth part, the return. Feeling sorry for his companions in the cave, who remained chained below, the slave returns to the cave to try and set his fellows free. His idea was to inform them of his findings, but upon returning he finds his vision so unclear that his companions think he has gone mad by leaving his place and traveling to the other world. They mock him because they do not believe him and refuse to leave the world of shadow that is their reality. They even threaten him to put him to death if he should try to set anyone else free. The other prisoner's reaction to escape returning represents that people are afraid of knowing philosophical truth and do not trust philosophers. So, Plato's allegory of the cave is one of the best known, most insightful attempts to explain the nature of reality. The cave represents the state of most human beings, and the tale of a dramatic exit from the cave is the source of true understanding. The dialogue between Socrates and Glaucon is probably fictitious, composed by Plato. Whether or not the allegory originated with Socrates, or if Plato is using his mentor as a stand-in for his own ideas, is unclear. In conclusion, it can be said that Plato's allegory of the cave evaluates a journey from darkness to light. The story represents our opinions through the influence of others. In the beginning of the story, Socrates is talking to Glaucon and told him this fable to illustrate what it's like to be a philosopher. He says, most people, including ourselves, live in a world of relative ignorance. We are even more comfortable with that ignorance because it is all we know. When we first start facing truth, the process might be frightening, and many people run back to their old lives. But if you continue to seek truth, you will eventually be able to handle it better. In fact, you want more. It's true that many people around you now may think you are strange or even danger to the society. But you don't care. Once you have tasted the truth, you won't ever want to go back to being ignorant. I believe that this quote has a significant part into understanding the story because it hits every aspect from using your senses to finding the truth.